I think his strongest point is in laning phase. He's really confident in laning phase, but after laning phase and in team fights, he seems to struggle a little bit, where he's a little bit too passive and is too afraid of auto taking. And that's something we saw the last years. But if he improved with it, I'm not sure. We'll see. But he's definitely a good AK. I think they're still one of the weakest teams, probably with us as well. But if we look at our stream results, we should win it.
Mr. Rallis commenting on what he saw from Freeze the last years. Wow, it seems like he has a fan. Welcome back. We're about to get into our final match of the day as MeetYourMakers look for their first win of the split against the Copenhagen Wolves. Let's dive straight into the lineup for MeetYourMakers. In the top lane, it's Mimer jungling Horo in the mid, Blizer at AD, Mr. Rallis support Nisbet, and their coach Yamato Cannon. 0-3 start to the season for them. Poor performances in the first three games, but I think in this one it's important to recognize that they had the hardest start to the season of any of the teams under their circumstances.
Yeah, for sure, with their mid laner getting replaced just a few days before it starts, like, I couldn't even imagine putting myself into that position. And well, one of the shining lights for the team for sure is Horo. He did really good, especially on Lee Sin, and Rengar was pretty solid. Like, I'd like to see him on these strong early game junglers and just try to take the lead early and run away with the game.
If you take into account that Horo came onto that team and was practicing with Corey, and then he has to build up that same synergy with Blizer, how long does that take, if you could put a number in? A couple of weeks?
Yeah, there's, of course, the language barrier as well, so I have no idea. It might take weeks, even months, so just gotta keep practicing hard, play that duo queue.
Yep, Mr. Rallizer was mentioning on Freeze's play that he thinks that Freeze is a little too passive when he comes out of laning phase, but Mr. Rallizer, we've seen him on Sivir a couple of times. It doesn't seem like he's feeling himself, because last season he was a very revered AD carry.
Yeah, Rallizer is still playing quite solid, but not really having the impact he used to have. Like, he was praised as one of the best in Europe, which is to say a lot, because we have these god tier AD carries in Europe, and this so far he hasn't really proven himself yet.
Yeah, we'll see how it plays out in this one. Now for a look at their opponents on the red side, the Copenhagen Wolves in the top lane, Youngbuck jungling, Airwax in the mid, Soren Freeze at AD carry support Unlimited, and their coach Dentist. Now, coming into the season, we asked the questions, how will the solo laner step up here for the Copenhagen Wolves? Youngbuck didn't have the best experience yesterday, but on the other hand, Soren versus Froggen, he was able to hold his own and even get that solo kill, so that could be something for Soren to maybe go by and trying to do something in this mid lane.
Yeah, Soren is kind of this mini Bjergsen, like, he even has the same name. He just needs to reach his potential. I know potential is a word that gets thrown a lot, but I think if he practices hard and the team starts doing a bit better, he can really have good games.
Mr. Ali was mentioning Freeze, as we said, he should be a little more active, but he didn't have the worst performance yesterday either. He picked Corki and he went 4-2-2, 3-KDA. It was a very long game. He was able to do some things. Can MYM capitalize on that in this specific matchup? Copenhagen Wolves, excuse me.
Yeah, Freeze played a pretty solid game looking at how his team was performing. He managed to not die a lot, farm a lot, and get some damage in. So I think Freeze is probably one of the strongest points in the team right now, and if he gets a good early game, who knows what will happen.
We will find out in just a second. With all that said, let's send it over to Quickshot and the Fee Show at the caster desk.
Thank you very much, Shox and Cyanide. We'll have to see whether or not Horo can actually step up and keep playing. His Rengar yesterday was decent, but I think the main storyline is, of course, MeetYourMakers trying to recover from losing their mid laner, and also for the Copenhagen Wolves, Youngbuck really needs to find his groove.
Oh, yeah.
He has had three very, very bad games. Decision-making's not been on point. He's been overextended despite knowing there was people around. And I think, you know, the two players you're going to look at on these teams, one will be Youngbuck to step it up, and one will be Blizzard to see... Blizzard. Say it for me.
Pusher's Blizzard.
Blizzard, thank you. And one for Blizzard to see how he settles in. You know, doing better, finding some confidence.
Yes, he's getting better and better. Again, he came straight from solo queue, never played any competitive games before joining the LCS the day before everything started last week. But honestly, this game here, MYM have been looking so bad in everything they've done because they have no other options than just try and play a bit of solo queue style, because you have no coordination with your new guys, you have no proper communication with Blizzard in the mid lane either. Like, how is it going to work? So it's not been looking good for them. Copenhagen Wolves, on the other hand, they go really late.
Yeah.
But they have a very weak early game they have to fix. It's going to be the opening for MYM. They have to win early game, in my opinion. Don't allow Copenhagen Wolves to scale up, because late game team fights, Copenhagen Wolves as a team will be more coordinated and should be better than MYM, who is still, again, playing the solo queue game.
Copenhagen Wolves took down H2K last week after giving up a massive, massive lead in the early game. And after 30 minutes, started to find those team fights. Young Buck on his Gnar found his groove. We've seen Freeze playing Draven, playing Kalista, yeah, and also doing very well in lane. He's come out even or ahead in almost all of the games. The problem is, by the time they get to that mid game, the rest of the Wolves lineup has fallen so far behind. Freeze's power is next to nullified.
Yeah, and it's too easy to dive the back line if your Gnar is 0-5 anyway. He's not going to protect anyone. You can just ignore him and go straight for Freeze or Zoran in the team fights. So let's see what we're going to have here in the pick and ban phase. Azir, the first ban by MYM against Copenhagen Wolves. We haven't actually seen them play it, but it's considered one of the strongest flex picks we do have in the current meta.
And of course, Rek'Sai, we're not going to see it again today. Last game here in Europe in week two, taken off the table. Cassio reply, Soren, of course, using that to great effect to bounce back from H2K.
And as Horo has been one of the shining lights for MYM, we see Copenhagen Wolves really target him. Rek'Sai, Lee Sin coming in. Jarvan is still left open. I do wonder if they want to have that as their last ban. Otherwise, it could be the first pick for MYM and then two strong picks going over to the Copenhagen Wolves. Maybe they want to try and make that trade here, but we have seen Horo play Olaf before. So it's not like MYM should feel forced to pick a Jarvan if it's left open by the Wolves.
On the same token, we have also seen Airwax playing Hecarim. That was against the Giants. We've also seen Vi once. So we'll see what junglers they decide to play with. I don't think we're too surprised to see emphasis on that Jarvan. Those last two bans were, of course, Lissandra and Gnar. So top lane and jungle being the heavy focus for both of these teams.
That's why I'm a little bit surprised the Wolves actually banned Gnar here as the last one. I thought they were going to try and trade Jarvan for Gnar or Gnar for Jarvan, depending on whatever MYM wanted as the first pick. So we're going to see what they will lock in here. If we're going to have two power picks for the Wolves. Zed is actually a champ that was banned against Soren, but we've never seen him played in the LCS. He's never really been the assassin kind of player. He's always been very teamfight focused, very late game focused, fairly passive in the laning phase, and now on a Zed. First time for him.
Well, we'll see how well he can perform on that champion. Gonna be make or break. What we've seen from most of the Zeds in EU is a lot more focus around those team fights, a lot more focus on getting in and sticking with your AoE, as opposed to the split pushing. And I think this is gonna be a narrative we'll talk about a lot more next week once we've analyzed some more of the games.
Yeah, what the teams do with Zed is they use him to set up the minion waves, but not stay there to take a tower. So he walks down because he's so safe. It's very easy for him to escape. He's, of course, very strong in the one-on-one, so he can safely build up a minion wave, and then he leaves, joins his team for a potential team fight, and then he can return after back to the bottom lane once the big wave has been built up and is pushing down. That's the way at least Fnatic has played around the Zed here. We're going to have to see if Copenhagen Wolves will do the same.
Well, a lot of time to tell before we figure that out. We did see the Sivir and that LeBlanc locked in for MeetYourMakers. Blizzard sticking to those majors. He's got two games in Ahri, one game on Kassadin. Now LeBlanc added in, all AP focused.
Yeah.
And you know what? He has gained confidence as the games have gone on, steadily growing. Let's see if he finds his groove. LeBlanc is a champion that can blow a whole lot of people up if given the chance.
Yeah, still not the biggest fan of going LeBlanc into Zed, because he can force you to build an arm guard early on and delay your own power spike a little bit. And it's a bit of a tricky matchup for LeBlanc against the Zed here. So we're going to have to see, because Blizzard now picks it into it. And I mean, again, for Zoran, this is the second time he's playing an AD champion in the LCS. Otherwise, it's all about the mages normally.
So we'll see how it works out for him. A little bit of unsurety, I think, is the side and Officio. Freeze will be playing yet another AD carry. It's his fourth champion in four games. Gonna pull the Caitlyn out, got the support of Annie. Let's see if the Wolves want to try any sort of fast push tower game. They've got a lot of range and wave pushing in their back pockets.
They also have a Rengar who has no speed ups to help him really pick off targets here. And we've seen this once before and it went really wrong. I actually believe MYM was the ones playing Rengar for Horror.
Lulu top, let's see it.
Could be a little top for Youngbuck. Would it add in to the fast pushing style with the Caitlyn pick?
And give you that magic damage.
And then you do have some split pushing going on with the Zed, so it could definitely be an option for
definitely be an option.
It's been a very long day.
It's game number 20 for Deficio here in the European LCS. We do see MeetYourMakers. They've rounded the composition out. Engage power from Leona, as well as that all in for Irelia in Mima's hands. MeetYourMakers signaling they want to go. And they want to go fast.
Strong lanes, a lot of pick potential coming in from them. Oh, sorry, not strong lanes, but strong mid game from MYM, and a lot of pick potential again, as we so often see here in Europe. Obviously, the Sivir and Leona, a combination we've seen a few times, works extremely well, because once Leona goes in, Sivir pops the ulti and everyone can follow, and whatever target is now stunned should end up dying, because there's no disengage from the side of Copenhagen. Lulu again would then work in for them if Youngberg wants to play it. And instead, this would leave them with a comp. It could end up, well, they do have Caitlyn for the late game, but still, if you do lock in a tank now and you run a Zed, you know the team or MYM will itemize against a Zed, making it very hard for him to find a target late game. Then it's suddenly all about freeze to deal the damage, and that's where you have the Leona, LeBlanc, the Irelia, Jarvan, everything that can actually jump onto freeze. So the Copenhagen Wolves here, by locking that Maokai, I do feel like in the late game, MYM is really just going to look for that one AD carry, and if they manage to kill him, suddenly it's going to be hard for the Wolves to do anything in these fights, but we're going to have to see what's going to happen.
There is not a lot of magic damage at all on the side of Copenhagen Wolves. No. I completely share that sentiment, Deficio. Once MeetYourMakers have the armor and the QSSs they need, you nullify Sorin and you mitigate freeze, a lot of pressure again on Copenhagen Wolves. Look at Unlimited. That's a stressed look if ever I've seen one.
Yeah, and also remember that Caitlyn and Maokai here is going to take a bit of time to scale up compared to Sivir and Irelia on the side of MYM. So they can really put the pressure on in the early to mid game, where if they do manage to get the lead from it, they're going to get up these armor items, they're going to get the QSS on the AD carry, and suddenly the Copenhagen Wolves are just going to lack so much damage in the late game. And you also run this Rengar when you have no speed ups to help him, making it very hard to actually find a pick for the Rengar itself.
So we'll need to see, again, so much pressure on Copenhagen Wolves. They need to come out the gate swinging. They cannot afford to give up the early game leads that they've done in the past. There are other players, of course. MeetYourMakers on top in the blue side, taking on Copenhagen Wolves. Guys, hit us up on Twitter, hashtag MYMWin or hashtag CWWin. Both of these teams looking for a much needed confidence booster here in the last game of day two. We're about to load up onto the Rift. MeetYourMakers versus Copenhagen Wolves. Let's see how these guys do. Banners, of course, lit up there. Beautiful addition to our stage. Thank you very much, Riot Production. And I don't know. I'm not sure about this Maokai pick. My doubts are cast, but it's up to MeetYourMakers. They've also not particularly shone in their previous games. If the game goes late, which Copenhagen Wolves have done, they've just got to be super, super careful not to give up items and armor early.
Yeah, that's going to be the problem for them. Even though, again, Maokai is very strong late game. We have Caitlyn, obviously one of the hyper carries in the game, but it's simply because you have so much physical damage on the side of the Copenhagen Wolves, and so many ways of actually diving the AD carry from MYM, and no real peel coming in except for the Maokai itself to help out freeze in these late game team fights. But MYM on their side, getting in the deep wards, they want to have this lane swap. Actually, they could do 2v2 if they want to. Leona has a fairly decent lane into an Annie, because she can actually all in her and Annie won't really be able to respond. But I wouldn't be surprised to see MYM go for the lane swap.
So let's see what they decide to do. 1 minute 30 on the clock, going to start backing away. MeetYourMakers desperately trying to get themselves on the board. Mima also not having the best opening games this split. He's gone Crystalline Flask, so let's see if he takes the harass.
Yeah, and Youngberg, of course, going to get the early level 2 from the Raptor camp, and the Copenhagen Wolves are lane swapping. And this, again, is not about this support matchup. It's because Caitlyn completely outranges, of course, the Sivir in the laning phase and don't want to deal with it. They know Mr. Rallis needs to get going early on. He's one of the carries left on the team, a guy they didn't have to rely on in the summer split, but now have gone back to a style where he needs to step up again if MYM wants to win any games.
So, Freeze pulling the minions there, trying to get control of the pace and the speed. Mr. Rolls solo up in his lane. MeetYourMakers have initiated their lane swap following their deep vision. Let's see what Youngbuck and Unlimited want to do. We saw some great low-level Annie play yesterday with some tower dives. And it looks like Young Buck's going to have the support of Annie, a potential invade. Horo's gone low, a couple hundred hit points, but not the focus. And it's actually Young Buck just getting a little sapling in front of the Raptor camp. Copenhagen Wolves, you're too late to the party.
Yeah, Copenhagen Wolves just got rebuffed right here by MYM.
Yeah, you'd think for a team that has a name, used to be a jungle camp.
Actually, am I lying?
A little bit.
I am lying, completely ignore everything I said. I didn't actually see Soren started on his own ripoff. Expected it. So typically, again, in the lane swaps, you do see people invade into the enemy jungle, take one of the buffs away from them because you know you have your dual lane on the top side, you have more players. But this time around, both of them actually just trading or doing standard jungle routes for each other. So no three buff for anyone. I was lying before, don't believe me.
So it looked like Copenhagen Wolves maybe anticipating a invade from MYM or something similar, maybe expecting Jarvan to stop blue. Didn't happen. So, MeetYourMakers come out a tiny, tiny bit ahead. Blizzard doing okay in this middle lane. Some damage down against Soren. Let's see how Soren can pull himself back. First time we've seen Soren on the Zed this year. And doesn't have the entire support of Deficio. Not a traditional champion we're seeing him on.
It's been a long off season. He's been able to practice Zed. I mean, the Assassins has come back into the meta compared to in the summer split where it was all about the Ziggs, Nidalee, Xerath and so on. So you're going to have to see what Zoran can do on the Zed here.
A lot of pressure on his shoulders. Airwax going to get the first crab of the game towards the Dragon. I actually think Horo may have secured crab in the top half. So it's one for each side thus far. We need to just see who's going to play this lane swap out. Now, you contrast this game to SK from previously, where SK have a very clear strategy with their AD carry, pushing down the tower, and then trying to roam around. It doesn't seem to be the case for actually either of these teams, and both MeetYourMakers and Copenhagen Wolves are playing more defensive and more passive.
Yeah, and right now MYM is very happy just keeping Mimer in a one-on-one so you can pick up farm and XP on this Aurelia here, because you want to get to your Trinity Force fairly early on in the game. That's your big power spike, as we always mention. So for him, getting this one-on-one lane, perfectly fine for MYM. I mean, they don't really care about Maokai picking up some farm in the early stages, as long as Mimer gets it as well.
Yeah, truthfully, MYM are going to be looking to get off a flank, I believe, in these team fights. With all of the mobility they've got, you can have Irelia LeBlanc coming in from the side to try jump onto Freeze. And as long as Soren doesn't get, you know, overly fed, it can be a good way to win those team fights.
Yeah, and just remember they have Sivir as well, so it opens up for them to engage multiple ways, either flank or actually run straight at Copenhagen Wolves when you then have the ulti from Nisbet, the Cataclysm from Horo to lock down a target. If you can do it that way, you can kind of ignore the Maokai and just like run past it. But the whole thing for MYM is they have to start the fights, because you don't want to let the Rengar create that pick here. You don't want to let unlimited flash tippers you and suddenly catch you out of position. So it's MYM who has to start the team fights against the Copenhagen Wolves, and obviously the same can be said for them. None of the combos really run any peel here. So it's about who can pull the trigger first.
Yeah, in theory, the team that's going to get that early advantage could take complete control of the game. I'm looking forward to seeing the combo of Airwax going in with that thrill of the hunt, followed up by an ace in the hole and death mark from Soren. It could be very scary. We did see Mimer going aggressive onto Freeze. Airwax is nearby, but we're interested in clearing out that jungle camp than helping out. Some good poke onto Blizzard, actually. And Soren doing okay. He's gone in with a death mark. That's very early. Doesn't manage to get the ignite down. Doesn't have the AD advantage, but that was the lane matchup you were talking about.
Yeah.
Zed has the ability to make it work.
And he's definitely winning in farm here for Soren. And remember, LeBlanc was picked into the Zed from the side of MYM and Blizzard, and now forced back to base. We see the early armbar again. This is what happens when you fall behind in the lane against the Zed. You have to respect his all-in potential, and suddenly you have to go for an armguard early, and that delays your power spike. No instant DFG, no Morel Normicon as your first item, and suddenly you are going to be weaker just because you have to itemize against the Zed.
I call it training for 5.2. Seeing as there won't be a DFG.
Could be.
We'll see what Blizzard can do. There are, of course, some 5.1, which I haven't actually said today. And Mr. Riles and Nisbet. So let's see. 60 CS. They're up in the top lane. They're pushing the tower down. Not necessarily focusing on keeping the wave out. Unlimited is left Young Buck's side. Nice to see Copenhagen Wolves adjusting their strategy. In the lane swap, they left some support with Young Buck to not allow him to get punished or 3v1'd in some scenarios. We see in the bottom lane, Mime is doing well to farm up. The tower has taken a beating, but it's not super close to going down yet.
The problem is, Mimer is now level 6, so diving him just as a support and jungler with 8 carries is not exactly going to work out too well for the Copenhagen Wolves, unless they know exactly where Horo is on the map. Because if he's nearby, he's going to turn it around, and suddenly MYM is going to win out on that one. Eryx is looking for, he's only level 4 in this ring out. He's very far behind in farm compared to the Jarvan.
Does have the support of a level 3 unlimited. Contrast that to Nisbet, who's level 5. There's some big level disparities, but it looks like Wolves, oh, they don't actually have control of this, but there's no response from the rest of MYM.
Now, MYM right now really want to get the top tower down. That's why they kept Nisbet in the lane, to make sure Youngba couldn't just sit and clear the waves, and Mr. Riles had no response to it. And once again, Soren goes in.
Got some damage, it's not going to be enough, despite having that Brutalizer.
Back to base.
But got lane control, and that's what you were talking about.
So I don't know why Soren actually went for Brutalizer as his first item. On Zed, if you want to all in your lane, you need to get Cutlass. It also allows you to roam around. Brutalizer will only give you more damage to your abilities, your poke, but all in, go for the Cutlass here. So Zoran should have gone for that if he actually really wanted to keep playing aggressive. And Mimer onto Unlimited. He's only level 3.
There's so much damage. Level 7, Mimer's going to have the support of Horo. Flash is available if he wants to Cataclysm down. The flash, the flag, the drag, the dunk freezes the next target. Freeze forced to flash away. First blood secured by Horo, a level 3 Unlimited. It's always going to be a possibility.
Again, coming down so late, and Mimer had just been getting free farm, free XP in the lane. And obviously with Horo being nearby, well, suddenly first spot over to MYM, and they can be happy with this lane swap.
And I think Copenhagen Wolves are going to be, you know, kicking themselves. They saw Horo in the jungle a minute earlier. He was in the bottom. He was trying to challenge for that red buff. Nisbet does not connect with the Zenith Blade, so unable to punish Youngbuck. Neither tower has fallen yet. However, we did see Mr. Riles and Nisbet putting some damage down earlier before they ran out of minions. And of course, Unlimited's death means the bottom lane has been interrupted for the time being.
Yeah, and again, Nisbet just been sitting in the lane with Mr. Riles to make sure they could always push it down and get a bit of damage on the tower. Didn't actually get it, and he's not been roaming at all on Leona.
Ooh, very aggressive. That was a flash from Blizzard.
What?
Not going to get enough damage to get the kill onto Airwax, maybe.
Did he just cancel it? I think he just canceled his own distortion by flashing, and therefore didn't get any damage on Airwax.
Timed it a little wrong. No flash distortion. Didn't work out this time around. Continuing to feel the pressure of that lane. But this is something that Blizzard has been doing in all of the games. He's attempting those flash aggressive plays. Think of his Ahri from last week, flash charms. Yes, they didn't often hit, but when they did, he was getting the kills.
Correct me if I'm wrong, Twitter, but I'm pretty sure that you cannot distortion flash on LeBlanc because it doesn't count as an animation you're starting up, and therefore him trying to do it here actually just meant that he just flashed onto Airwax and did no damage with it instead. So cancel his own distortion, gets no damage from it, no flash now, timed by the Copenhagen Wolves as well. And remember, Soren, he wants to go all in onto Blazer here, so might end up paying for it.
Let's see what Airwax decides to do. He was forced to use that Thrill of the Hunt defensively to deny the vision. 4 HP on the Blue Sentinel. Soren's eventually going to get there. A little bit of disconnection between mid lane and jungle here of the Copenhagen Wolves. Those towers are still standing, like we talked about. However, Mimer has abandoned the bottom lane. He has swapped with Mr. Riles and Nisbet and headed up top. Let's see how he does against Youngbuck. In the middle lane, Soren's gone very aggressive. He's got the death mark down. I don't think that's enough yet. Oh, that was close. Wouldn't have been enough, nevertheless. And again, Soren just maintaining control of that lane. 25 CS advantage.
Yeah, just keep going all in. There's no real response from Blazer. And that's the thing about this lane matchup. Once you fall behind, it's just an uphill battle for you. And now with the standard lanes in place, MY managed to dodge around the Caitlyn lane. And now actually a hidden farm on Mr. Rallis. And Blazer again keeps getting low and lower, forced to go back so many times in this lane here. Soren is in full control.
30 CS difference in that mid lane alone. Soren is getting a whole lot of damage down onto this middle lane. Gonna back out taking that single turret shot, I believe. We do see Youngbuck in the top lane, actually staying even with Mimer, yet to give up a kill. And this is a good sign for the Copenhagen Wolves. If Youngbuck is able to get tanky enough to keep Soren and Freeze alive in the mid game, that is where the Wolves need to find a lead. That is where they need to accelerate control, get Caitlyn to 3 items as quickly as possible, because there is a ticking time bomb. Once MYM have enough armor, you're going to have that shrinking efficiency of, well, Airwax, Sorin, and Freeze.
Yeah, and we see Jumbug now itemizing against Mimer here, getting the armor down early on. Because what Copenhagen Wolves wants to do once Blade is complete, or once they feel Sorin is strong enough, they want to put him in the bottom lane, keep Jumbug in the top lane, and just have Freeze sitting on this Caitlyn in the mid lane, safe wave clear over and over, and every time someone moves away, he can get a bit of damage on the tower, and slowly you're chipping away on three towers in three different lanes, if it works out for you perfectly. At least now with Zorn, he's down in the bottom lane already, feeling strong enough, no Blade for him just yet, but already now the Copenhagen Wolves splitting up in this 1-3-1 we're going to see.
Let's see if they can make it work. Airwax, throw the Hunt available. Got those Moby boots for a speedy engage. I think he's about to come running. Youngbuck also has Flash available. Twisted Advance is going to hold him in place. Here comes the kitty cat. He wants to purr. Mimer's rooted in place. Look for the baller strike. It does connect. Mimer's in trouble. Flash is still available. Down to 300 HP. Youngbuck and Airwax continue to chase. They're going to think about diving, and they back away. Flash is burned from the top laners, but Mimer gets out, and MYM set up for Dragon.
Just not enough damage here from the Copenhagen Wolves, and no flash for Airwax to try and finish off Mimer. Should be able to get a tower, though. Actually, no, Mimer has teleport ready, so he can teleport back to the lane and defend it, and a Dragon as well for MYM here. Things are going their way for once.
Oh, Blizzard, he's found Freeze. Freeze is low. Tibbers comes up. Blizzard's stuck down. Teleport's coming up from Youngbuck, but it doesn't matter. Freeze is down, and Youngbuck, I think, canceled that TP. So MeetYourMakers managed to get the second kill on the board, and well played from Blizzard. He set that up.
That was a very nice play, knowing his teammates were coming from the Dragon. He goes all in, trying to force Freeze and Unlimited to stay. Youngbuck now onto Horo.
Got some decent damage. Horo's going to get stunned up. This is going to be top laner plus support. Where is the rest of the Wolves? We do see Sorin coming up from the bottom lane. He secured a tower in exchange for those deaths. Still not the end of the world. The baller strike does not connect. So Airwax is going to back away. Copenhagen Wolves, they've given up kills. They've lost a tower now, which is going to be good for MeetYourMakers. That's going to keep the tower trade even. And of course, kills in favor of MeetYourMakers.
Yeah, Sorin did manage to get a tower in the bottom lane for himself, so he should be able to get the play deleted. But I don't think MYM is going to allow him just to sit and split push. They're going to engage onto the Copenhagen Wolves, like we saw Blizzard just do beforehand in the mid lane, because they have enough hard engage on their side to just force Sorin to either recall or be in a very bad situation where his team might die because he's not there with them if he's in these split pushing situations. So as long as the MYM team can make sure Sorin can get a tower from it, they can actually choose to fight themselves.
And with MeetYourMakers grabbing themselves a Infinity Edge as well as Trinity Force, there's a very scary position to be in. Freeze has been chased. Sorin chases him down. That death mark pops him. That was a well-executed play, and Blizzard should not have jumped to the shadow.
Blizzard should never have even been in the bottom lane in the first place, knowing that Sorin has been there before and then can just easily go down again. You don't want to try and one-on-one him. You're way too weak on the LeBlanc. Let him push in the wave. Meet him at the tower where you can just wave clear it safely. You have the shield from the tower as well to avoid the all-in, and that's how you deal with the Zed for now, unless it's Mimer going against him, but he's going to need an armor item before he really wants to take on Sorin.
Yeah, we'll have to see if we can get that. Copenhagen Wolves again, signaling that they want to engage that red buff. Keep in mind, Copenhagen Wolves tried to steal away the first one, but they were late to the party. They did steal away the previous spawn and now this one. So decent enough control from the Wolves in MYM's jungle. And Sorin with that kill, really a good confidence boost. He's actually grown his CS advantage to 60. And Airwax, realizing he's caught way out of position, forced to do another defensive ultimate. That's actually quite impactful in a Rengar when you consider how powerful and how important getting kills with that champion is for the Copenhagen Wolves lineup. He can't afford to be using it defensively.
No, and I mean, Airwax, if you look at his performance so far in the LCS, it's not been anything to write home about. I mean, he's had some poor games. I remember his Hecarim game yesterday on Jarvan as well. Actually going Juggernaut in China, I believe. So playing it very passive normally, very defensive, and not really had the impact we saw from him in the summer split. Because in the summer split, he was the guy also making plays for Copenhagen Wolves early on. He had a lot of deaths, but he would get a lot of kills at the same time.
Yeah, he was one of the players we were praising during week one, actually, talking about how important Airwax was because Youngbuck and Sorin were not necessarily the carries during the summer split in the few wins that the Wolves had strung together. So the Wolves still trying to find their footing here in the 2015 season. They lose themselves a tower in that mid lane, and MeetYourMakers slowly clawing some control.
And we're now seeing Blizzard stay very far back here, wait for Soren to leave the lane before he clears it, and now he is back to his tower, otherwise he might die again. And he is actually pinging Soren, so this time he stays alive. Erwex has joined him, but he has no ulti, so he can't really use the Rengar. And you don't have your ulti ready at this time. And MYM is going to be happy just getting a tower, but a very, very slow-paced game here.
Yeah, approaching both 20 teams. Minutes. Only 800 or 1,000 gold separates both of the teams. Mr. Riles happy to keep farming away. Under no pressure this game, and Freeze also didn't have that head-to-head matchup, so he hasn't had the same lead that we've seen in previous games.
Yeah, and I do wonder what Youngbug is going to build here. If he actually wants a Rod of Ages or not. Because if he's getting it this late, he's just delaying stacking it. He's delaying his own tankiness by quite a lot. Just by getting this early armor through the Warden's Well. And he's sitting on the Ruby Crystal. So I want to see if he actually wants a Rod of Ages or not. Maybe Righteous Glory could be the goal for him, seeing as he's not getting the Rod of Ages early.
We will find out shortly. Not too long to wait. Soren was chilling in the bush though, waiting to see if Pleaser was going to close up and try to farm, but doesn't do the case. Blade of the Rune King completed, continues to accelerate ahead and as far as the CS
again.
Is concerned.
He's sitting down in this bottom lane, he's pinged by MYM, and they're moving down towards him. Maybe Blizzard can bait it here.
Well, we'll see. Gonna be a little scary when your bait can get insta-gibbed before the rest of the team can respond. Distortion used from Blizzard, so...
But again, he's staying at his tower.
So that's the important thing, use that shield. Use the defensive wave clear. Soren really wants this kill. He's been chilling in the bottom lane for what, 3 minutes, 4 minutes now? waiting for Blizzard to...
And now MYM is reacting to it. They see Mr. Rada stuck in the mid lane. Teleport actually coming in from Youngbug here. Erwex trying to engage. But he's a slow Rengar with no speed ups.
We'll carry on. That was basically it. I mean, MeetYourMakers trying to make a play. Does not work out for them. Teleport burn from Youngbug for absolutely no
Blizzard.
Available. Here comes Soren. Blizzard's going low. Blade has been popped. He's going to distort away. Going to get that ultimate as well. He's just put distance away, but Flash was burnt. Yeah. So Soren again maintains control.
Very important dodge here. The Q from Soren. And now Youngbug.
Oh, we're going to have a fight. Youngbug does manage to use that twisted advance onto Horror. He's got caught out. MYM are in retreat. There's no on the hunt available for Mr. Riles' Sivir, and that means they're going to give up position on this dragon. The Copenhagen Wolves started the buff, they're going to secure it.
Yeah, MYM really wanted to fight because there's so few ultis ready for the Copenhagen Wolves. Zoran has none, Erwex of course used the one earlier as well, so they're still staying around, they're not done yet, they know they can actually take a fight.
So let's see what MeetYourMakers can do. Youngbug and the rest of the Wolves forced to go the long way around to the inner turret. The minions are not there just yet, so MeetYourMakers unable to get on the tower. Copenhagen Wolves able to reposition. They get the dragon. They keep it relatively even. Deficio, I think we're in for a long one.
This is looking like it. Oh, Blazer wants a piece of Soren.
And Soren's going to be able to get away. Going to be able to use that shadow to dash to safety. Soren, decent enough attempt, punishing the little bit of vision that Copenhagen Wolves did not have, but it did not avail. It did not gain any advantages. And I say we're about as even as you can get.
Yeah, I do feel like MYM could actually go on for the engage around that dragon, despite Blizzard not being there quite yet and running from the base. But just because there's no ultis on members like Erwex and Zoran. In the end, though, MYM plays it safe. Tried to push in the mid lane, didn't work for them at all. And we are back to sitting in our side lanes. Blizzard once again. Trying to follow Zoran around as the guy defending, just staying alive around his own tower.
This is actually quite a good game. Oh, we'll get to that. Blizzard gets stunned down. Death marks up. 1, 2, 3. Blizzard's gonna pop. And Zoran gets out. Yes, they needed a flash for that. Now, can Mima turn it around? He continues to chase. Gonna have the support of Horror, but Airwax joins the party. Stealthed up, invisible. He's partying alone because there's no one to jump on. Another thrill of the hunt from Airwax that is gained nothing.
Yeah, but Sana said on the analyst desk, Mini Bjergsen here for the Copenhagen Wolves on Zed. Making a few plays in the early game. So quite a while before he reached the real Bjergsen status, though.
We'll have to see if he can turn the tide of this game. Early Quicksilver Sashes on the side of the Copenhagen Wolves. Makes sense against Leona. There's no ultimate for Airwax. He's got no Quicksilver Sash, and all the damage is put down. This bit of Mr. Rawls with an easy, easy kill.
I'm not even sure why he's moving there in the first place, but Youngbuck pushing the bottom lane. Blazer once again sent to try and clear it. Last time around there was a Zed and he died. This time there's a tree and he's walking away.
Gonna get those mimicked ethereal chains. Youngbuck's gonna turn it back around. Let's see who's gonna win this trade. Taking absolutely forever. Blazer's gonna distort in. Ignite's ticking. Youngbuck's in trouble. Gonna twist
the wrong one.
He hit the clone. He hit the clone. It's not enough. Here comes Blizz. He doesn't get the distort.
That was close.
The minions are gonna put some damage down, but Blizzard comes out ahead. Eventually winning the duel. That's gonna be a confidence builder. Spider-Man supports the play.
Took a while here, but of course the full armor build from Youngbuck in the fight here. Now he's actually picked up some magic resist against Blizzard here, but it's a nice little pickup for him. That was very close. Youngbuck just has 50% chance, and he got the wrong one.
The one thing that I really think this game is highlighting is just how far ahead teams like SK are in comparison to the rest of the league. You consider at 23 minutes how many towers have been pushed down, how the lane swap had played out, the sort of advantages that SK had garnered for themselves, the picks that they have found. You contrast Airwax's Rengar to the likes of Rainover and, you know, from Fnatic, for example. And there's a lot of growth that both MeetYourMakers and Copenhagen Wolves have to do. And it's just stemming from really an inability to push with the objectives or push with the team comp you have. Airwax has used 60, 70% of his ultimates to run away from
people. Yeah.
That is not what Rengar is designed to do.
No, and he's constantly looking for kills around Sorin, but Sorin can do it on his own, forcing Maima away from this lane. And right now, again, it's all about Sorin on the Zed. He got the tower in the bottom lane, he got the tower in the top lane now, and nobody can deal with him one-on-one. Maima is trying to build armor, but he can't stop him, and now Rallus responding like he should do as the Copenhagen Wolves are investing so many guys on the top side, get something in the bottom lane.
So let's see, they're gonna trade towers. Bottom outer secure for MeetYourMakers. Copenhagen Wolves gonna get the top inner. He's gonna close the gold league, but it hasn't stopped MYM. Youngbuck now, one versus three. Gonna use that vengeful maelstrom to wave clear. Gonna have the support of Freeze in the background. And MeetYourMakers, they haven't stopped yet. On the hunt, available for Mr. Rawls if he wants it.
And this again really where we see the problems for MYM and lack of communication and strategy, because Blazer, while all this has happened, has just been sitting in the mid lane. He didn't join in on the bottom side to potentially pressure it even harder. He didn't actually go to the bottom end to defend. And now though, finally they're able to push up the mid lane and not really gaining anything from it. He should have either been defending the top lane from MYM, or he should have been pressuring with MYM on the bottom lane. Instead though, ended up just doing nothing.
So, got himself some farm. Needs all that he can get at this stage in time, falling very far behind. I think Copenhagen Wolves subscribing to the Let's Build Tanks build, strategy. It's been a long time since I've seen QSS on your mid and AD carry as a second slash third item. And really just afraid of that engage. They want to be able to survive long enough to put damage down. But we haven't seen an extended fight yet.
No, but the reason for Freeze is he knows he's going to sit and be the wave clear bot here, and MYM wants to engage on him instead of trying to deal with Sorin in a split push. So he needs that QSS to stay alive and escape whenever Nisbet lands an ulti on him and actually stuns him. And obviously for Sorin, it's simply because if you get locked down as a Zed and you can't juke around on the shadows, you can't get full damage from the ulti, well, you won't be able to kill the target. And again, he also knows he's going to be split pushing all game long. And
AOX found the target. Tibbers did not. Unlimited, unable to stun everyone, but the solar flare was good from Nisbet. Now Copenhagen Wolves, they're split up. They're in retreat. Here comes Sorin from the sideline. Deathmark is down on Blizzard. It's not going to be enough to kill him. We do see Nisbet's gone down, and despite the chaos, it's actually MeetYourMakers that come up behind. Copenhagen Wolves have got position on Dragon. MeetYourMakers not looking to challenge. Oh, no. Blizzard did try for a second, but it was the Wolves that secured the second Dragon of the game. And a slightly sloppy fight from all parties involved.
Yeah, but right here again, because Youngbuck is building so tanky, and because Sorin is so far ahead of Blizzard, Copenhagen Wolves take the fight despite not having two items completed yet for Freeze, two damage items completed for him. So this is the point still where Caitlyn wants to stack up and get stronger into the late game, and yet the Copenhagen Wolves win the fight, get the dragon. MYM not able to use his Aurelia, and obviously Mr. Rylas and Blizzard barely managed to do any damage in the fight. He just had to disengage very, very fast. That's a mid-game spike though still for MYM, where they are very strong and could punish the likes of Freeze on this Caitlyn here before he hits the three-item spike.
I'm a little bit nervous for the Wolves. MYM has got himself the Frozen Hearts. Horo's got himself the Randian's Omen. Hourglass getting closer for Blizzard. Despite all the work to keep him down, he's slowly building up that power.
Yeah, so MYM will of course be very tanky in the late game with all the armor. But Jomburg as well on this Maokai. Skipping Rod of Ages, just going full tank instantly. No HP, nothing for him. The fact that Sivir is so bad at killing tanks late game is a problem. The fact that LeBlanc doesn't want to go for the tank either is a problem for MYM. So they don't really have any tools to kill Jomburg when he's going in. And that means he should be able to buy enough time as long as Freeze and Soren can actually stay alive for them to deal the damage. But we're going to have to see late game. It's going to be some long team fights because there's going to be a lot of tanky stats on everyone and not a whole lot of damage coming in.
Reminds me of H2K versus Copenhagen Wolves. H2K got themselves a super fed Sion who was just mega ultra tanky. And in the late game, it was the mega ultra tank that actually ended losing. So let's see what Soren can do. He's up against MYM, who's got that Frozen Heart and a Giant's Belt. Not going to stop Soren thinking about going in. Deathmark is out. Ignite is there. Soren is going to win the duel. Even with all that HP and armor, MYM is actually grinning on the player cam. Soren on Zed, he's convincing me to fish
him. Oh yeah, he's playing really well on this Zed here.
Mini Bjergsen, as you said.
Mini Bjergsen, he got the last Whisper. He got the one-on-one, and that was MYM under the turret, and he still managed to kill him and get out alive. So now, Baron started by the Copenhagen Wolves. Baron stopped by the Copenhagen Wolves, and instead, looking to engage.
Airwax does not manage to find the stun. Does on the second time, leaps over, and nobody else from the Wolves has followed. Another thrilling hunt that's not so thrilling in my books. Airwax been unable to find the picks with that champion. But MeetYourMakers, they dissuade the Baron. They stop the Wolves from securing that objective. And we just keep going back to this sort of slow pushing game.
Yeah, but because Copenhagen Wolves have the Zed, who's finding the kills and able to always get something at least for the Wolves, they can go back to this. Let Soren do the one-on-ones again, maybe even one and two if it should happen. And then I really want to see Unlimited pick up a Talisman on his Annie here. Sell his gold for 10 items, the spell please. Get the Talisman instead because you need that speed up for yourself and for your Rengar if you want to try and pick off MYM. If they do send two guys down to kill Soren, because that's going to be the test for Copenhagen Wolves. Can they actually punish MYM for sending two guys to kill Soren in the split push? If not, then MYM can use that to stop the whole thing and basically shut down Soren.
Well, we'll see if Soren can maintain any form of control for the Wolves. We're 30 minutes in. 45k to 44k. Unlimited's going to stun MYM. It's not going to do a whole lot. MYM is going to get rooted, and that might be enough to dissuade it. Another slow comes out from Airwax. He's 2 for 2 on the baller strike. Lisa comes in, though. The chains do not connect. He's looking for a mimic. Actually, he used it to dash over the wall. Unlimited and Airwax are able to get out cleanly, despite the pressure from Blizzard. What have the Wolves done elsewhere? That's given Soren the time to get the bottom inner turret. Gonna take gold even, but it's super, super close at this point.
Yeah, MYM is starting to find some picks around the map because they don't want to deal with Soren here. When you have a Sivir though, and they're comp, they have to run as 5. And honestly, just start pushing up a wave or a lane, and then if Copenhagen Wolves keep Soren as a split pusher, you gotta use your speed buff and your high burst from like an Aurelia and a LeBlanc together to just go for a dive. I mean, you have to go for someone like Freeze when he's trying to wave clear. Land that ulti on him from Nisbet. And obviously just saw him dance around here. But they gotta create some picks together. You gotta use that ulti from a Sivir for your entire team and not just like one by one by one. Because then it's too easy for Copenhagen and Wolves to just back away and wait for Soren once again to make the plays.
That's the only strategy the Copenhagen Wolves are doing at the moment. Outside of dragon spawning
it's
and the
basically like the old Copenhagen Wolves when we actually had Bjergsen. We would just sit back and farm and wait for him to make the plays on Zed. We're back to the old days, a circle of life. The circle of the Copenhagen Wolves.
Hakuna Matata. We'll see how they do. 50 seconds before the next dragon spawns. Now, the previous dragon, Copenhagen Wolves were able to push MYM away, despite the fact that their engage was somewhat scattered. Look at Soren looking for a target. You have to think both times have got the timer on this.
And again, now we have that 2v1 in the bottom lane from MYM. So now Copenhagen Wolves need to be able to get a Baron for it. They need to be able to get a pick on the 3 guys from MYM staying so Soren doesn't die for nothing in case he goes down. For now, MYM saying, you know what? He's sniffing us out here. We're going back to 5 versus 5 in the mid lane.
5 versus 4, Zed's not there.
5 versus 4, sorry.
5 versus 4, Zed's not there. We'll see what he decides to do. Soren continues to push. The irony is, we were talking about split push and how it's somewhat falling out of favor. And you can actually see it in these comps. Still lots of focus on engage. But because of the incredibly slow pace, Soren is being given the time to push the rest of the map. So Soren continues to push on the bottom lane.
No
Wolf
pink
has spotted
though,
Baron.
From Copenhagen.
It's in full vision. Copenhagen Wolves have not scanned the pit.
They have to use pink wards here to deny vision from MYM. So they can actually take a Baron like that when Soren is getting all the attention in the bottom lane.
Now the question is, can MeetYourMakers get any sort of vision or control
no.
of the dragon pits?
They're going back.
They're not going to. Not really taking advantage of Copenhagen's Wolves decision. Soren gets the minion wave up to inhibitor turret. And let's go. Round number three. Attempted Baron. Finally going to sweep out the pit. Vision is denied from MeetYourMakers. But, like you said, Deficio, pink wards are needed and there's none in the inventory for the Wolves.
Yeah, not enough wards around their Baron total from the Wolves, so they don't feel confident enough starting it. Remember also, Mima has teleport and Soren does not, so he won't be able to join if Baron is started by the Wolves. And we go back towards the Dragon, where Soren is nearby, so he can join in.
So more item breakpoints that I think are very important to note. Mima, Randian's completed, as well as a Quicksilver Sash for Mr. Ral. So the number of targets that Soren can find are sorely being diminished. Dragon uncontested here by MeetYourMakers, secured for the Copenhagen Wolves. We're up to number three for the Wolves, one for MYM. At the 35-minute mark, gold is still as even as it can be at this point. CS, despite there being massive disparities, you know, 70 difference between your top laners, call that 120 difference between your mid laners, 50 for AD carries, it sort of balances out in terms of the breadth of power. More marks completed for Youngblood, but you know, the other thing is, you have to say it out loud, this is very worrying for both MeetYourMakers and Copenhagen Wolves in the bigger picture. Not only are they struggling to find any sort of advantage against one another, this is part of the reason that these teams are struggling to pick up any wins at all in the LCS.
100%, I don't think anyone will disagree. Awex, face checking Horror.
Well, we'll see. He should be able to stealth up and run away. He's done it a few times before. Gonna get spotted, leaps in, does get taken out. Defensive ulti, this should open up. Baron for MeetYourMakers.
And now the first time we see them sit five together and actually look for a pick with the Sivir ulti where they speed up everyone. They find Awex. Soren is still in the bottom lane. So there's only three guys here from the Wolves trying to stop this Baron. Mima's gonna go back to base here. He has teleport ready, remember. Youngbuck, he's going in.
Youngbuck has engaged. He's very tanky, but there's not a lot of follow-up. They needed Soren. First kill will be secured by Freeze. They've stopped the Baron. Copenhagen Wolves have got control of the bottom lane. Let's see if Soren can actually find anything. We do see Horo. He's gonna flag and drag away. Soren, he's gonna activate the Ghost Blade. Deathmark is down, looking to hit the Shurikens. Ace in the hole with the Deathmark secures the kill. Now Youngbuck's re-engaged. Mr. Arles forced to use that QSS. Youngbuck goes down. The tree is down. Freeze is trying to get away from Mima, and he does. 5.1 base gates. It's successfully been used to save Mima's life. Copenhagen Wolves have stopped Baron, but I think are too low to take it themselves. And this is very, very risky. Let's
Don't you ever tell the Copenhagen Wolves what they can and can't do. They're going back to the Baron now. Or at least around the Baron.
Just want the crab. Going to secure the objective, deny the vision. Going to back away. So yeah, they stop MeetYourMakers. They do get a few kills. And even I'm surprised that they got through the tankiness of Horo. But Mimit did not go down in that little engage. And like you said, Deficio, the 5v5 for MYM. They needed a Deathbush gank. Death Bush setup, but it worked. And
yeah,
let's see if they find that again.
They can try again, and this time around, try and get more than just Airwax down and actually go back to that Baron if they wanted. But the thing is, diving a tower is hard, yes. But in your situation, oh well, this would be caught here.
Well, Turbos came out as well. He's a bit still alive.
Does a flash.
Gonna try flash over the wall. Actually opts against it, turns it around, finally flashes away. Nisbet gets out alive. There wasn't enough damage from the Copenhagen Wolves. Now the re-engage. Cataclysm is down. Mime is chasing from the side.
Blazer's here.
Does not connect with the chains, and Airwax goes out. Three members of the Copenhagen Wolves cannot take out the support of MeetYourMakers. Youngbuck is getting chopped down like a great oak. And Copenhagen Wolves lose two after trying to take down the support of MeetYourMakers.
And again, Mima still has teleport ready, so you can go back to base. defend against Soren here while the rest of MYM is pushing up. Two kills and suddenly really starting to use the Sivir ulti to create these picks here and force the teamfights on the Copenhagen Wolves where Soren is not there. And again, this is one of the reasons split push has not been used very often, because once you're sitting in that side lane, there's so much engagement the other team in most of the comps we see in the current meta. They can just force teamfights on you, get the kills they need, and suddenly you have to go back from the split push, because otherwise you might lose a Baron, you might lose your base, whatever it is.
So MeetYourMakers bouncing back from that sort of team fight defeat that they suffered at the Baron. Here's a replay of this engage and Nisbet getting out.
Yeah, the bait from Nisbet here, staying alive in the very end. So it's actually Copenhagen will start in the fight, but now MYM joins in Mimer. This time around he blocks as well the ulti from Freeze. And then Sivir ulti being popped, Horror jumping in. The fight is on. Soren, look at your minimap. He's down the bottom lane. He's not in a position to get a tower forward because he's too far away from them. And that's why, again, MYM can go for the fight and then recall for Mimer so he can defend after.
It even felt like there was a little bit of miscommunication in the MYM camp, because Mimer was in full retreat. You saw Mr. Rawls coming in with a Sivir ulti down, and Mimer was actually backing away, and all of a sudden, Horo goes for that very hard Cataclysm engage. Maybe I'm just reading a little bit too much into it. MYM end up coming out ahead. They got the towers, they got two kills. Now they're looking for more. Youngbuck in a little bit of trouble. Cataclysm is available again. It's down. Mimer's going to dash into the pit. Lisa's going to use those ethereal chains and all that tankiness of Youngbuck.
Yeah. And instant Mimer recall back down to the bottom lane. MYM keep pushing out the bottom lane, so Soren has to push it back in. That buys time for them to get a pick, go back to base for Mimer, defend again. This time, though, they also got to care about the mid lane.
So let's see what Copenhagen Wolves can do. They've split MeetYourMakers up. A little bit of trouble. That's a decent Yordle snap trap from Freeze. That's a lot of damage on that mid inner turret, and Soren is just chipping away at that bottom turret. It's down to, if I can click on it, 600 HP out of the 250. So it'll go down with a couple of hits.
That was not a bad trade by the Copenhagen Wolves. Mid tower as well went very, very low beforehand. So they have two low towers now, one on the bottom lane, one in the mid lane. If next time MYM does the same, these two towers should go down. And obviously we're getting towards the fourth dragon, the Wolves setting up around it. And MYM, even though they should have the stronger teamfight here with the right engage, have not been doing anything around these dragons. Just all been in favor of the Copenhagen Wolves.
We really need to see who's going to take advantage of this game, because it's just small plays here and there. Very small plays, because neither team is committed to big objectives. This might be a full-blown team fight. First one in a little while. MeetYourMakers on the dragon, so it will start beating away on them. Soren's going to be a little late to this party. Look at the minimap. He wants to potentially come from the side.
Oh, he's going to flank. There's no wards behind MYM here.
Well, Airwax is going to go on that thrilling hunt.
Look at Youngbug as well.
Both nothing's
him
happening.
And Soren, though. No, both him and Soren are setting up here. They want to come in from behind onto Mr. Alice.
Oh, actually, you know what? It was the movement speed from the crab. Dragon secured by MeetYourMakers. So Airwax now actually has his ultimate ticket.
Him.
Now he jumps in. Let's see what Soren can do. All the pressure's on him. Got the death mark down. Solar flare comes out from Nisbet. We see Freeze going down. That's a lot of damage away for the Copenhagen Wolves. Youngbuck takes out the support of MeetYourMakers. Here's Bleezer doing the work that he can. Horo gets another knockup. The Copenhagen Wolves are being melted. Airwax will be killed where he stands. And Unlimited is in full retreat. MeetYourMakers with Dragon and a convincing team fight.
Soren used his ulti on Nisbet in this fight here. Didn't want to
you sound very confused, Officio.
Well, the thing is, so there's a QSS on Rallis, but still you want to use to get the shadow just near him so you can actually jump to the shadow and you can auto-attack Rallis down, not rely on your ulti, which might have been what he actually tried to do. I just want to see the replay in itself, but they didn't manage to kill Rallis, even though he got locked down by Youngbug. And if we saw here, MYM, once they got a proper team fight, proper engage, again, 5v5, they get to Freeze, they kill him, they have so much armor on Irelia, on Jarvan, that it's near impossible for Freeze to do anything. Okay, let's see it again. So the flank actually from the Copenhagen Wolves. Freeze at the moment is left all alone, there's no peel for him, so he's gonna get engaged on by Blazer. Now Rallis here, okay, so ulti from Soren onto Nisbet, and then he actually gets in to try and hit on Rallis, but he's not hitting him. He's actually hitting Nisbet and not Rallis. That's why he stays alive. And also another reason for the Copenhagen Wolves losing the fight.
Well, the first things you learn when you play League of Legends is don't focus the support. You need to get rid of those carries, even more so when you're one of only two damage dealers on your team. Soren with the first real misplay, dare I say it, on this Zed. He's been doing a good enough job. But MeetYourMakers, finally, after 40 minutes, have started to group up, have started to realize, hey, in 5v5s, we're pretty good.
Yeah, now
and
you
need to punish it more.
Yeah, now you get to the point as well where the Zed suddenly can't split push because you know MYM is going to push onto your base and you're needed there to actually defend and be ready. Otherwise, MYM might just dive onto you. So, good situation now for them, for the MeetYourMakers. And all this armor, I mean, Thornmail, Frozen Heart, Random Zoom in, everything for MYM. Freeze won't be able to do a thing.
So, finally, we have a clear, clear lead for MeetYourMakers. Around 6,000 gold in the advantage. They've got a Baron. They took the most recent dragon.
They should just dive right here. Just dive onto Copenhagen. You see Soren in the bottom lane. You just go for this one. Lock down Freeze and kill him.
Let's see what they do. Horus looking for the dive. Here comes Blizzard and Nisbet. That's a very good solar flare. Unlimited is down. We do see the tower secured by Mr. Riles, and they turn to Youngbuck. They're going to take Maokai down as well. Blizzard flanking from the side. Ace in the hole gets blocked off. It was Mr. Riles that ate the bullet. MeetYourMakers are going to take the inhibitor as Soren's trying to save. We see the Quicksilver Sash coming out. The first victim of MeetYourMakers will be Mima. Now Copenhagen Wolves trying to turn. Freeze is the only man standing. After 43 minutes, MeetYourMakers finally get control. The towers are down. MeetYourMakers are going to get on the board in the spring split by defeating the Copenhagen Wolves. It was not pretty, it was not exciting, but it was a slow grind that MeetYourMakers ended up victorious with.
Yeah, first win for them, at least giving some confidence. They're going 0-4, so...
Let's be fair, look at those faces.
Yeah, I mean,
those aren't even celebratory faces.
You know it was a sloppy game, but you also know now, okay, you got the first win. You will be down in the bottom of the standing if we look at how it looks at the moment against the Gambit. Copenhagen Wolves, of course, Giants 2-2 for this week. So every single win against the teams around you is going to be so important because you just want to dodge this number 10 spot where you're automatically down into the Challenger Series and won't get to play relegation and fight for your spot in the LCS. So this win, despite MYM not looking too happy about it, was very important for them.
I do agree, and I also think for Mr. Riles in particular, 5-0-9, that's the first time in 2015 that I think he's had a decent performance. I do say that very, very loosely because truthfully, only Soren actually looked good this game. He had a few mechanical plays. I feel like he was pressuring the map. But just as teams, both MeetYourMakers and Copenhagen Wolves have to go back to the drawing board and figure out how should they play their comps? How should they push the map? Because we really didn't see any decisive play at all until 40-odd minutes.
Yeah, that's very true. MYM took a bit of time before, started grouping and actually just forced these fights on the Copenhagen Wolves and forced Soren to go back from the bottom lane. But once they did it, they also did play it very aggressive. From winning the dragon fight to getting the Baron to finishing the game, there was only like 2 minutes at max. So they knew once they actually had a big enough lead, okay, now we know what to do. As soon as Soren showed himself in the bottom lane as well, just dive onto that inhibitor turret, don't even care. Kill Freeze, kill the Copenhagen Wolves, finish the game.
And I also want to go back just a few minutes because, you know, one of the things that started turning it in MYM's favor was the face check by Airwax near the Baron pit. He did go down and fight sort of ensued. Then like very shortly after that, Airwax was waiting in the bush, jumped into Nisbet. Didn't get the kill. And again, MeetYourMakers sort of turned it around. Those two fights seem to sort of ignite MeetYourMakers and say, oh, hey, in these 5v5s, we're doing well. We're positioning correctly. Nisbet's solar flares were good. You know, in the team fights, he was hitting multiple targets and doing his job in a more impactful way than Unlimited's Annie.
Yeah, and the thing is, once you have now started the LCS and you lost 3 games, you know you have a team where it's not working properly, synergy is not there. You feel very scared to make plays in the game because you don't want to be the guy losing it for your team. You want to play very passive, play very safe. And that's what MYM did until they saw an opening and realized, oh, we can actually win this game. We can actually fight. We can actually make plays and suddenly start doing it. So yeah, Airwax face checking at the Baron was the first thing for MYM realizing we're actually in the game. We still have a chance. Despite Soren doing so well on the Zed here in this big push.
Yeah, and quite impressed by Soren. Hopefully Copenhagen Wolves can make better use of Soren's Zed in the future. For now, though, for a Riftside look at that game, let's actually hop onto stage where Pyrotechnics is standing by to talk to Blizzard, who has joined us after securing that win.
Thank you very much for that one. Quick shot now, of course, as you mentioned, I am here with Blizzard 300. First of all, congrats on your first win in the LCS. How has that felt coming into this team, very new and all?
Well, it feels really good. like we were pretty confident going into this, but we didn't really show it because I think this game was pretty sloppy, but we still won and we're happy for that.
All right, a win is a win. So happy to take it indeed. Now, I also wanted to ask you, since you kind of came in a whirlwind here, you've been really making some plays, you stood out on the team, but in general, how has it been settling in and just being thrown into the LCS like this?
Like it felt pretty crazy. 3 days ago, I was like normal, just in school and stuff, and going right first game on the stage with the team, so it was pretty crazy.
I can only imagine. Are you living in the team house as well now?
Yeah, right now I do.
Very, very cool. So I also wanted to ask you about your coach, Yamato Cannon. A lot of people have seen him in the past. And how do you think his impact has shown through on your team so far?
I think Yamato Cannon is a really good coach. And I think he brings a lot to the team right now in the strategy advice and just to the team.
Thank you very much for joining us, Blizzard. Now to send it back to the desk and wrap up the day, we're going to throw it over to Shox at the desk.
Thank you very much, Pyra. Interesting you mentioned that Yamato Cannon was helping them a lot with strategy, and before that they said this game was super sloppy. So we'll see if it's just something they have to get used to. About this game, we said in the beginning, the guys that could stand out for MeetYourMakers, Horo can make some plays, and he did actually do it in the early game. He got some things rolling for MYM.
Yeah, it was really important Horo got rolling this game because Blizzard was getting one-on-one really heavily out CS'd by Soren, and the fact that Horo managed to get some kills really kept them in the early game.
Yeah, you mentioned it. Soren was actually having a pretty good game on that Zed and able to split push, which was really being a menace for MYM.
Yeah, it's a bit weird to see split pushing right now. We don't see that a lot, mostly because like the tier 2 turrets now give the shield, so it's extremely hard to just dive someone under it. And Drakes and Nash have such great importance. And also the fact that it kind of backfired because his team was just getting caught all over the place when he was bottom and he was not really accomplishing anything after a certain point.
At what point do you think MYM recognized the fact that now, at what item threshold that they could just go down and kill him? And also freeze, actually.
Yeah, well, it was like 20 minutes, nothing was happening. Soren was just sitting in a brush spamming the Zed dance thing and then at some point, Irelia just had so much armor, she was like, okay, I'm immortal, I can kill everyone, and they just went to teamfight and won the game.
Let's take a look at one of the teamfights. Let's get that up on the screen. It's actually a clip where Nisbet, the new support addition for MeetYourMakers, gets caught, but if we can get that clip on the screen, a replay of Nisbet. He goes in as Leona, and he seems to be getting caught, but instead of going back out, is this the right clip? Yeah, there it is. And he has flash, but he doesn't jump out and he waits for his team.
Yeah, here, just Nisbet running away, getting somehow away, and then the bait is complete. Of course, Soren here just bottom, really not accomplishing anything, and it's clean up 4v5, just really good for MYM here.
That's also a pretty good sign, I think, for MYM. Trevor was mentioning that he think maybe it was a little bit of miscommunication, but to me, if your support, who hasn't been on the team for that long, holds onto his flash instead of jumping over the wall to get out, knowing that his team is coming and that trust, that's good for them.
Yeah, of course, he just looked at the minimap. He saw Zed is bottom and my team is coming, so I'm just going to bait these dudes.
Yep,
on me.
Just going to bait these dudes. Let's get another replay up on the screen for MYM, because from there, they realized that they had a pretty good team fighting company can make it happen. This is a fight around Dragon. If we could roll the clip.
Yeah, CV is just so split here, and Horror going in, no fear. Airbox forced to jump on someone not so important. Blizzard doing actually a really good job here, stoning Freeze, killing him in the end, and now just clean up duty. I don't know why is the Nisbet support getting focused here when Rallis is just next to him, but now, yep, just a clean up. Soren can't do much at this point with his ulti already gone.
Yep, well played by them. Very welcome win for MYM. How much does one win like this go in terms of, are they really going to get going now with that one win? Did you see some things here that will give them some confidence?
Well, at least their game plan was pretty good, just like farm out the Zed, being strong, and just fight when you have a lot of items, because you're going to win late game for sure against that full AD comp, because you only have to buy armor, they have to kind of buy everything. So at least that was good for them, and like I said before, you need that first win to get your confidence up, and when it's up, then you just roll with it.
Roll with it. At the end of week two, let's take a look at the table. Fnatic and SK Gaming are still undefeated at 4-0 at the top of that table. Then Elements is in third at 3-1. Gambit Gaming is still without a win, 0-4 at the bottom of the standings for Gambit. As you said, Gambit is one of those teams, they have to get one win to get going.
Yeah, and for me still. SK Gaming by far the most flawless team. Like, their strategy seems very solid and all the players really good.
Yep, kudos to them. Playing a key role in Element's win earlier today was their AD carry Reckless, who went huge with 11 kills, 8 assists, 567 CS, and 2 triple kills. This not only earned him a total of 45 fantasy points, but the title of today's fantasy LCS leader. And you gave him a hug earlier. Did you absorb any of those points?
Nah, not really, but he's a really good hugger, so.
All right, we'll just leave that for a sec. All right. Well, throughout this week of games, there were 5 players that were key to their team's success with performances that are truly worthy of the title OP. First up, worth a mention, is the Unicorns' love, Kickiz. He introduced Rek'Sai here in the ULCS when it wasn't banned. He went 8-0-10 as Rek'Sai versus the Giants. And even today, versus SK, he put up a pretty solid performance.
Yeah, he was one of the top performers in his team with Jawan when they were getting pretty much somehow wrecked.
Yep, the second one is Fabiven. Last week he had an 18 KDA over 2 games, this time only 11.5, but he was instrumental for them once again. I wouldn't say 11.5 is that bad.
Yeah, like I said, I wish I had those kind of KDAs.
Great play for him. Next mention is for SK Gaming's top laner, Freddy 122. He's used to playing those tanky top laners. He went for 2 AP champions in this one, and he just sets up so many plays for his team.
Yeah, bringing that cannon into the LCS, doing really impressive plays, initiating those fights, being a huge part of the win.
Yep, they actually had a 396 GPM, that is through the roof. Next up is Elements' mid laner, Froggen. Fantastic for him, and I feel like this is the Froggen we've come to know and love beforehand. He's really been able to rack up those kills and actually had an 87.80 kill participation in 2 games.
Yeah, it's the god tier Froggen we all know very well.
Last up again for SK Gaming, Forgiven. How can we not mention him? 24 KDA in 2 games, the Immortal Zero. That's an incredible confidence, as he also displayed here with us.
Yeah, he was really confident, and I don't see any reason why he shouldn't be. He was doing so good.
Yep. Next to that, I also actually want to put in a honorable mention for SK Gaming as a whole. All of them played fantastically, but Forgiven, the Immortal, deserves a mention here. Now, drawing from this week's of games, we have also chosen to highlight one player that put on their backpack and carried their team to victory. He consistently gets every one of his teammates' lanes rolling, is bringing the bro laugh back to the LCS, and this week's MVP, Fnatic's reign over. And Cyanide, you had a lot of say in this. You think he really earns the title of MVP this one?
I don't actually know how this noob got it now. Just kidding, he did really well. Like, not only is his early game super impressive, but he plays later on in the game like a solo laner almost. Like, he stays so impactful throughout the game, doing those amazing plays with Rengar, really being the initiator Fnatic needed in those games. And even with Olaf, his early game was not so great, but at some point he was like 4 levels ahead of Diamond and was just wrecking everyone.
Yeah, and hitting every axe. Congratulations to Reignover for getting that MVP title. That's all for this week, but the European LCS picks up again next Thursday as H2K takes on SK Gaming. We'll see Fnatic play the Unicorns of Love, and the Copenhagen Wolves will face Gambit. That all starts next Thursday at 6 p.m. Central European Time. That is 9 a.m. Pacific.
Yeah, I'm really looking forward to the Fnatic versus Unicorns of Love. I will never stop believing in these mythical creatures to impress me.
You never should. As things quiet down in Berlin for the week, they're just getting started over in North America. The NALCS picks up for week 2 tomorrow with Gravity versus Team Dignitas, while Cloud9 will look to find their first win against the undefeated Team Liquid. That all begins at 9 p.m. Central European Time, noon Pacific. Wow, Cloud9 tries to find their first win? It sounds so odd even.
Yeah, it's really Cloud9. We know them as the kings of NA, but Team Liquid doing so well the first week, and let's see if they can dethrone the kings.
Yep, it'll be a great game. That's all for week 2 here from Berlin. I'd like to thank Cyanide for lending us his expertise on the desk this week. And on behalf of myself and the entire broadcast team, thank you for tuning in. Good luck. GG.
Banners are lit, the stage is set, it's game 1 of day 2. Jumps into the middle of it all, Hootie, Zhonya's Hourglass, Big Wild Breath of Kamishar, collateral damage, Pinoy trying to make the difference, Reignover though picks up Edward, Fnatic on their way to a 4-0 start. Perhaps the Timbers is going to land on Whirlip, who will flash away from this one. Oduwamne, Big Gnar smash!
When I ban, when I put a ban, my face is very big. Indeed, you.
Yeah, same.
My face is really big.
Same, baby.
No, my face is biggest.
This could be the opener. A double kill to Reckless. Rocket is blasting off again.
He
SK are in place. They pulled out Chachi. Chachi's thrown in, rated against the wall. The first victim will be Hillisang. SK stay at the top of the table. Aura's looking for the dive. Here comes Blizzard Nisbet. That's a very good solar flare. Unlimited is down. We do see the tower secured by Mr. Riles, and they turn to Youngbuck. MeetYourMakers are going to get on the board in the spring split.